In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and shortcomings, and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord Jesus, you came to reconcile us to one another and to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You heal the wounds of sin and division. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you intercede for us with your Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. May the martyr Saint Boniface be our advocate, O Lord, that we may firmly hold the faith he taught with his lips and sealed in his blood, and confidently profess it by our deeds. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the beginning of the second letter of Saint Paul to Timothy. Paul, an apostle of Christ Jesus, by the will of God, for the promise of life in Christ Jesus, to Timothy, my dear child, grace, mercy, and peace from God the Father and Christ Jesus, our Lord. I am grateful to God, whom I worship with a clear conscience, as my ancestors did, as I remember you constantly in my prayers, night and day. For this reason, I remind you to stir into flame the gift of God that you have through the imposition of my hands. For God did not give us a spirit of cowardice, but rather of power and love and self-control. So do not be ashamed of your testimony to our Lord, nor of me, a prisoner for his sake, but bear your share of hardship for the gospel with the strength that comes from God. He saved us and called us to a holy life, not according to our works, but according to His own design, and the grace bestowed on us in Christ Jesus before time began, but now made manifest through the appearance of our Savior Christ Jesus, who destroyed death and brought life and immortality to light through the gospel, for which I was appointed preacher and apostle and teacher. On this account, I am suffering these things, but I am not ashamed, for I know Him in whom I have believed, and am confident that He is able to guard what has been entrusted to me until that day. The Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
To You, O Lord, I lift up my eyes.
To You, O Lord, I lift up my eyes.
To You I lift up my eyes, who are enthroned in heaven. Behold, as the eyes of servants are on the hands of their masters.
To You, O Lord, I lift up my eyes.
As the eyes of a maid are on the hands of her mistress, so are our eyes on the Lord our God, till He have pity on us.
To You, O Lord, I lift up my eyes. Please stand.
I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Whoever believes in me will never die.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Some Sadducees, who say there is no resurrection, came to Jesus and put this question to Him, saying, Teacher, Moses wrote for us, if someone's brother dies, leaving a wife but no child, his brother must take the wife and raise up descendants for his brother. Now, there were seven brothers. The first married a woman and died, leaving no descendants. So the second brother married her and died, leaving no descendants, and the third likewise. And the seven left no descendants. Last of all, the woman also died. At the resurrection, when they arise, whose wife will she be? For all seven had been married to her. Jesus said to them, Are you not misled, because you do not know the scriptures or the power of God? When they rise from the dead, they neither marry nor are given in marriage, but they are like the angels in heaven. As for the dead being raised, have you not read in the book of Moses, in the passage about the bush, how God told him, I am the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. He is not God of the dead, but of the living. You are greatly misled. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
If you are following our readings, most especially our Gospel, yesterday, Jesus was cornered by the groups of the Sadducees, by the Herodians, and today we heard him around the group of the Sadducees, ang mga Saduceo. And the most biblical scholars would describe this group as people at least with a very notable intellectual ability, mga matatalinong tao. At ang mga pinag-aralan nila would at least bring them to a life of being called as elitist. But what seems to be notable today were the words of Jesus to this group. Hindi sa pinuri sila ni Jesus, kundi tinanong pa nga sila, "Are you not misled because you do not know the scriptures and or the power of God?" And maybe you will be asking also why those words from Jesus, even if these men were intellectually gifted and all. And this is something, my dear brothers and sisters, we need to remind ourselves and open, and even to open our eyes with. We all know that human intelligence develops. Natuturuan, nagagabayan, tumatalino o gumagaling ang tao sa buhay, sa iba't ibang klase ng pag-aaral, ng mga talento, ng mga kakayahan po natin. We face the advancement of technology, of science, multimedia, philosophies. Say it, madami pong mga lumalaki at lumalagong kaalaman sa buhay po natin. At muli, ang mga ito, ginagawa tayong matalino, ginagawa tayong may alam. But sometimes, let us also care as well when human intelligence fails to grasp even the basic of human experience. Let us also be mindful how some, shall we say, growing ideals may eat up and even disregard the basics even of faith. May mga pamamaraan para maging maalam tayo ang tao, pero minsan inilalayo lang tayo nito sa Diyos at sa tunay na buhay bilang kapwa-tao. And I think those were the reasons why Jesus told this man, "Are you not really misled? You don't know the scriptures or the power of God." Jesus faced the Sadducees not to condemn their intellect, but by saying that they missed something. They have missed the basics and the simplest in life. And this experience has a lot to teach us, as I've said. Let us be careful with how we take learnings and knowledge, because it might slowly drag us away from the basics of life. Name it all: relationships, faith, needs, ang pagiging kapwa-tao at marami pang iba. Huwag naman sana dumating na sa dinami ng ating natutunan, kinalimutan naman natin ang pagiging kapwa, ang pagiging karamay at ang pagiging kapatid. At mas masahol, makalimutan ang pananalig at pananampalataya sa Diyos. While it is good that we learn and grow what we know, let us not forget faith and the basics of life. Mahirap na matalino lang at baka makalimot sa mga bagay na simple at payak sa buhay na ito. Matalino nga, pero ayaw naman magpaturo sa Diyos. Matalino nga, pero wala namang puso. While we all give thanks to God for our intelligence, for all our capacities, let us also ask God to bless us with healthy relationships, with warm spaces to accommodate people whom we love and care, and most of all, to ask the Lord for the gift of faith that is strong and fruitful.
Please stand.
How glorious is the peace and hope of resurrection. Let us pray with hearts free from foolish doubt or hesitation, because we believe in the promise of the one who rose again to eternal splendor. For every petition we shall say, God of the living, hear us.
God of the living, hear us.
That the Church may continually preach the good news of the resurrection and the life to come. Let us pray to the Lord.
God of the living, hear us.
That in our daily lives, we may bring the light of hope to those who live in darkness and despair. Let us pray to the Lord.
God of the living, hear us.
That Christians everywhere may not be people of legalisms and outward observances, but people with a heart who do what they have to do because they are God's children. Let us pray to the Lord.
God of the living, hear us.
That the sick and those who suffer may discover the healing presence of Christ in their lives. Let us pray to the Lord.
God of the living, hear us.
We pray for the dead and for those who mourn their loss. May the resurrection of Jesus bring them hope and comfort in their grief. Let us pray to the Lord.
God of the living, hear us.
Let us pray in silence for our own intentions, for all the intentions offered in this Mass, the prayers of our brothers and sisters joining us via online streaming, and our prayers for one another. Let us pray to the Lord.
God of the living, hear us.
God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, God of the living, to whom all are in fact alive, grant the petitions we bring before you through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Please stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Look upon the sacrificial gifts we offer, Almighty God, on the feast day of Blessed Boniface, and grant that we who celebrate the mysteries of the Lord's Passion may imitate what we now do. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you are glorified when your saints are praised. Their very sufferings are but wonders of your might. In your mercy you give ardor to their faith. To their endurance you grant firm resolve. And in their struggle the victory is yours, through Christ our Lord. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration, and we, with all the host of angels, cry out, and without end, we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all of the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. By the power of this mystery, O Lord, confirm your servants in the true faith, that they may everywhere profess in word and deed the faith for which Blessed Boniface never ceased to labor, and for which he spent his whole life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We will be having our Wednesday family rosary tonight at 9 in the evening, and this will be hosted by the Manila Cathedral staff to be led by the Gatdula family inside the Adoration Chapel of the Cathedral. We continue to pray and ask the intercession of the Blessed Mother to pray for the families and that the gospel of life may continue to prosper even in the midst of the many threats to marriage, to family, and to all of us. We also ask the intercession of the Blessed Mother to pray for every family and for every one of us. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration has been offered. Go forth in the peace and love of Christ.
Thanks be to God. Amen.